Hi nerds, hi yogis, welcome to a Nerdy Yogi YouTube channel and a Nerdy Yogi studio. Carlene Rose here, and I'm excited for our bombshell blast today, inspired by Supergirl. We are going to be doing a yoga shred inspired move called Fierce Chair Twist Turbo Boost. Very exciting. We'll be getting into our asana, if you know what I mean, and our calf muscles. Figure since Supergirl's always jumping and flying away, might as well. Tap into those muscles just like her. To start though, we're gonna come into a downward dog to warm up. So ground your fingertips into the earth, plant your hands down, light on the palms, and start by just pedaling out the feet. And while we're here, we will inhale deep to the low belly, expanding everything in our low belly and diaphragm, and exhale, squeezing everything in and out. One more inhale here. You can let your heels fall naturally towards the earth. From here, we're gonna bend everything and wave ourselves forward to plank and lower through chaturanga. Inhale here, prepare. Exhale, waving yourself in and up. And exhale, back to down dog. Inhale here, prepare. Exhale, wave yourself forward to plank. Come onto the knees again, lower through chaturanga. This will give us good shoulder health. Inhale here, prepare. Exhale, waving in and up. And exhale, back to dog. And last time here, inhale, prepare. Exhale, waving yourself forward, coming onto the knees, lowering through chaturanga. Inhale here, prepare. Exhale, rolling yourself in and up. And making your way back to down dog. Awesome. From here, you'll just walk your hands back to your feet, really ground into the earth, rolling yourself in and up, coming into a mountain pose. Exhale, hands to heart center at namaste. Now I will come here to the center and face you so that you can see the move. You can just hang out wherever you want on the mat. But we are going to start by grounding our feet solidly into the earth and come into a chair pose. And you don't have to worry about being super connected. I want you to find a comfortable chair position. The important thing is we want to make sure that our knees and toes are in alignment and we are putting the weight in our heels. So we're not sitting in chair pose coming forward, but we're sitting in chair pose going back. From here, you'll inhale and exhale, left elbow will touch right knee, right leg. Inhale through mountain, come back into chair, twist the other direction, inhale here. And this time when you exhale, fists of fire come onto your toes. So a bit of a challenge, there's a lot of moving pieces, obviously, so go at a pace that you can maintain. It doesn't have to be super fast. We've got plenty of rounds to get plenty of work in. So I will start my Tabata timer here. So again, start by getting a good grounded position in the feet. You can start in mountain pose. And we'll begin. Inhale up. Exhale, sitting back into your chair, left elbow to right knee. Inhale up. Exhale the other direction. Inhale up. This time, lift the heels. Awesome. Inhale here, right elbow or left elbow to right leg, opposite side. Inhale up and onto the toes. Awesome. And you can step side to side as you calm your heart rate a little and take this at your own pace. You can go faster, slower. I want to make sure I'm going at a pace enough that I can talk to you about the alignment. So inhale here, exhale, sit back to chair. Inhale up, exhale. And onto your toes. And it's okay here if you lose your balance. And if you're going at a fast enough pace, you can always come onto the toes twice. This is your practice. You want to make it fun and challenging and something that, you know, you're actually going to do. Awesome. Start by mountain and twist. Thank you. want your heart rate to get going a little bit on this exercise. So even though there's lots of moves, you want to make sure, of course, alignment comes first, but you also want to see, you know, what pace you can bring it to. Obviously, as always though, alignment comes first. Alright. So you see, you can take it at a variety of paces. You can mix it up too. Maybe you start out slower, get faster, and maybe feel like you're getting a little worn out. So the next round, you take it a little slower and get back into the alignment of it. Making sure you are sitting back on your heels in chair pose. Again, your practice, do what makes the most sense. Listen to your body. That's really the key here. All right. And walk it back and forth. Slow your heart rate down just a little bit before doing another round. And if you feel like, notice that your alignment's falling off a little, take it at a little slower pace. Awesome. And that's it. That's all you had to do for today. Not that bad, right? So walk back and forth. Calm the heart rate down before we get into our cool down. You can stretch out the arms. You can exhale lion's breath. Good. Sigh, get out any of that extra air that you didn't exhale while doing the hard work. So from here, coming back into down dog, start by pedaling out your feet, bend everything close to the earth. This time, inhale, lift the right leg high. Exhale, step it through your core plank, bringing the right foot to your right thumb, planting into the earth with your left hand. Right arm reaches up towards the sky. And we'll just do some circles here, bending everything close to the earth and opening to a reverse triangle here. So bending towards the earth, coming up into a stretch. Exhale. Last time here, hold in a moment, rotate the right palm behind you and come into a half bind for a couple of breaths. Awesome. Plant your hands into the earth. Step yourself back to your downward dog. Inhale here, bending everything. This time, left leg lifts up high and comes through core plank. Stepping left foot to left thumb. Inhale here, prepare. Left arm lifts to the sky, and we will rotate or circle, bending everything close to the earth. Opening it up. And last time here, this time holding that stretch a moment, rotate the palm behind you, then come into the half bind. Stretching out the legs that we just worked out so much. into the IT band as well. And make your way back to down dog. Now from here, find whatever way is the most comfortable for you to walk yourself back into your Shavasana, final resting pose. If you need to take any other yogi's choice poses, feel free to hit pause, stretch out anything that you feel still needs to be stretched, and then come back to your final resting position here. I hope you enjoyed that bombshell blast. I had a blast with it. Definitely subscribe to the channel to make sure that you get notifications for when the next one comes out. I, of course, have also the League of Nerdy Yogis email list with some exclusive content for you, so be sure to check it out. Namaste.